This video shares with you the precautions for installing the chip. When loading the chip, these points can be ignored. This pad is special, the chip can be placed according to the corresponding position of the pad pin. This is the chip on the Android motherboard, and the positioning frame is marked here. First, let's place some solder flux paste. Do not spread the flux paste, see what effect will appear later. The chip is placed on it, and it should be placed according to the edge of the positioning frame. For motherboards without positioning frames, the chips can be placed according to the distance between the surrounding small parts and the chips. After placing the chip, heat it with an air gun. It is best to be perpendicular to the chip. The minimum temperature of the air gun is set to above 280 degrees Celsius, and the wind speed is the maximum. Flux will overflow from the bottom of the chip. That's why we didn't flatten the older flux paste in the first. But there is a problem here. If you put too little, the underside of the chip will not be fully leveled, and some pins will not be wetted. There is a risk of short circuiting. If you put too much, this will happen, and the chip will drift. At this time, reduce the flux paste or reduce the air volume of the air gun. We replaced the chip, there was no more drift when reheated. Soldering oil will still overflow when heated, but this overflow is within a reasonable range. After the chip is completely melted, observe the chip carefully. The chip will have an auto-reset movement with a small range of movement. If there is a large movement range, it means that the chip is biased, and there is a risk of short-circuiting. If you are not sure, you can also touch the edge of the chip with tweezers, perform a manual reset. This reset action is not obligatory. Spread the flux paste is the best way. The most important thing here is to preheat the motherboard first, and then put the flux on it. Next, put the chip on for heating. The air gun is set to 280 degrees Celsius and the wind speed is the maximum. After heating, there is still solder oil overflow, and then the chip will automatically reset. After heating for a while, reset it with tweezers to make the pin pads fully contact.